Alright guys, welcome back. I'm here just with a quick tutorial video on how to use the industrial information panel. Some people were asking on my last video how I set that up, so I thought I would just make a quick video to explain it. Basically, all you do is you need to first get a sensor card from, you can do it from like an energy storage device like an MFV or a tank. You can also use it on the energy counters and the Gregtech stuff. I believe this is for nuclear stuff though. And there's also a remote sensor kit, which is for nuclear reactors. I'm just going to show the liquid and the energy sensors here, because they're the simplest, and that's what I've used. So first, you just need a card. Just use the sensor kit on the device you want to measure. And then you need the actual display. There's both the display panel and the extender. Extender just makes the display bigger. I'll show that in a second. And it needs a redstone signal. So you can just shift click a lever on and turn it on. Nothing will show until you put the card in. And once you put the card in, you can like you see all the text there with all the stats, and you can give it you can actually type something there, and it centers it above it, which is pretty nice. And you can customize the units on the front there. You can get rid of those. You can also remove different items that it will display, so you can kind of customize it like that. Add some extenders. And it tries to pick a rectangle. You can't have like weird shapes or anything. But yeah, that's how you build it and get it displaying info. There's a couple upgrades. The range upgrade and the color upgrade. So for the range upgrade, it actually has a limited range on what it can read. And if you look on the cards, they have the coordinates there. So you can kind of, if you forget which one is which, you can look and see. But if I was to put this in here, it's going to give me outer range. So just put in range upgrades until it starts to work. Yeah, there you go. So yeah, it does have a limited range, and if your device is far away from your display, it's actually not that far. You're gonna have to add some upgrades, but they're pretty cheap to build. And then there's the color upgrade, which gives you this button, and you can just pick whatever color you want on your display, and you can basically choose the screen and the text color like that. And that's all the upgrades for it. A couple things about the energy devices. If you have multiple devices, which I'm sure most people do, you can combine them together and you get this, and it shows you card quantity 3. You can do up to 6, I believe, is the maximum. You can put that in and it shows you all three individually, as well as the total amount, and you can actually disable each card info just to get the total amount. And of course you can say, you know, power status or something, whatever you want, and that's all your MFEs together, which is pretty nice. That's what I do in my Let's Play. And then there's the liquid sensor kit. Just grab one of those. Looks like blue, like that. Use it on the tank, and then you can just pop it in there, same deal as before. Gives you the liquid name, amount, how much is free, capacity, and the fill percentage. I'll actually disable that and say biofuel tank. But there you go, that's basically all there is to it. It's fairly simple. The main part being combining those energy cards is a really nice feature, and I'm sure those who build the nuclear reactors appreciate this as well. But yeah, there you go. Hopefully that was helpful. If you liked it, hit that thumbs up.